Just, you knew where everybody was.
Oh. That's the way those guys are going to be Sunday. You and I are going to cakewalk. Oh.
You're just going to walk around and give free
guys to celebrating?
Yeah, actually, we are.
You happy what you just did?
Yeah.
Pretty damn happy.
You do a little gang up plan. There's always a streak of numbers. That's what you guys always do.
It works damn well. Spots.
It works damn well.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Because hinging on what you just did, you just gave me a hell of an idea. Because I was needing a main event for the end of the show on Monday Night Raw. So since you guys think you're so tough and you got that stupid smile on your face, you give me a hell of an idea. It's going to be Randy Orton versus Bill Goldberg.
Randy Orton versus...
Hey, Randy Orton just versus Bill Goldberg. I hope to hell that all hell doesn't break loose out there, guys. I hope nobody gets hurt. That's all I got to say.
Is that what you got to say? Yeah. You know, I was thinking about all hell breaking loose.
Yeah,
right. Because that could be a problem.
Of course. We could turn the table just like that.
Can you? Three against one. Just like you do. You like to gang up on people, right? Well, since I considered that also, I figured that maybe for this match, there might need to be a special enforcer.
Yeah. Big deal. Who's that going to be?
Who?
Well, let me think about that.
He's got his thinking cap on.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Wow! What?
You like it? I'll be the special enforcer. You like it?
What a night! This is, everything is completely out of control. Well, Stone Cold Steve Austin, is he? I want to say here. Stone Cold is the self-appointed special enforcer for our next match, Goldberg versus Randy Orton. I strongly suggest that Randy Orton not cross the rattlesnake, but quite frankly, the same goes for Goldberg, King. The rattlesnake, the special enforcer, next. And we are awaiting your arrival of a man that can taste the heavyweight championship of the world. Well, you'll have to get it done inside 10 tons of steel in the Elimination Chamber this Sunday.
I fail to see all the excitement here. Just Goldberg. Now Randy Orton's going to beat him after that, right, King?
That could be a big embarrassment for Goldberg if Randy Orton beats him here tonight. Well, Rick, you weren't embarrassed when he beat you last week, were you?
Let me tell you, if I've been in there all alone with no interference, every time I'm down there, someone's jumping in and getting in the way. He was in my sights, JR.
Goldberg about to make his way to the ring. Looks like he's about to make his way to Phoenix this Sunday. Randy Orton and Goldberg both will be in the Elimination Chamber. And I gotta believe that Randy Orton would love to be the world's heavyweight champion.
JR, you're looking at a third generation member right there, man. Orton, he's got Orton blood, buddy.
Well, Rick, where do you stand Sunday?
I'm going to be where I need to be. And that's nobody's business but the world champion.
Let me ask you this, JR. Are you truly questioning the 16-time heavyweight champion? Are you questioning his loyalty? Is that what you're doing?
I'm just wondering if it came down between you or Randy Orton where Flair would hang his hat.
It's not going to come down to anything. What it's going to come down to is, once again, I'm going to show the world that I am the be-all, end-all, that I am the game.
Randy Orton kind of run like a scalded dog there to get out of the ring, but back in there, and a knockdown by Goldberg. Goldberg coming with nothing but power here.
Let me ask you this, Triple H. We heard Randy Orton say that he wants you to come out as the world heavyweight champion out of that elimination match. Do you really believe him? Can you trust him?
I can trust Randy Orton. I can trust the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and they can trust me.
Evolution. We don't have any problems internally. It's Evolution. We know who the champion is. We know who's going to win.
So Randy Orton doesn't want to be the world heavyweight champion.
Not on Sunday, he doesn't.
I think some people disagree with that, Nature Boy. I think it's going to be every man for himself. I think when it comes down to nut-cutting time, who can be the world's champion is going to be the world's champion.
Oh, look at this.
JR, are you watching? Go problem when you're watching. That's Orton tearing up Goldberg. He won't make it to SummerSlam.
He's always trying to stir things up. He's always trying to put the spoon in deep and stir the pot a little bit. And what ends up happening is somebody comes along and turns up the heat. How's that burn doing, JR, huh? Yeah. Maybe you ought to put some cream on it.
He looks like Nebraska.
There's a cover right there. Oh, that ain't going to happen. You know. And Randy Orton mounting Goldberg here, those right hands.
He's bitch slapping him.
Give him his punk card back, Randy.
What about the wild card in this whole thing right down there? Stone Cold Steve Austin, special enforcer.
Hey, Austin, the favor he is, if he knows what's good for him, he won't move.
I think that's where he's supposed to stay. He's a special enforcer, Rick.
Where else Austin's trying to make himself look important by putting himself at ringside, but he's a smart man. He ain't going to stick his nose in this, because if he does, we're going to be on him.
I just think there's going to be five hungry men wanting to be the world's heavyweight champion, Triple H. And in all due respect, you got the richest prize in all the business over your shoulder right now. I think everybody that's worth a damn wants what you have.
There's going to be five hungry men and one man that, hell, might as well be considered a god in this business, and that's me, JR, the game. I'm going to walk out Sunday just like I always do, world heavyweight champion.
Look at that streak from Goldberg. But Triple H, not to be argumentative, but the odds are against you. I think you would agree with that. You were in this environment last November in the only other Elimination Chamber match has ever had, and you lost it.
That was a fluke.
Oh. Shawn Michaels beating you was a fluke.
Look at this. Shawn Michaels beating me was
Randy.
A fluke. That press slam by Goldberg was a fluke.
Trying to convince yourself or our television viewers, but in any event, Goldberg now has reasserted himself physically here. Goldberg pointing right back at you there, gang.
It's a lot of talk.
Randy is wearing him down. That's right, Randy. He's beating a thumb right through his eye.
Goldberg shoving off Orton, and there went.
Hope that referee's all right.
Well, Blake, how's your torn groin? You're not going to be 100% Sunday, are you? And that's what Goldberg, no rip.
Hey, Austin, get out.
But Austin's in. There's a cover. 1-2
And I told Austin he better stay out of that ring.
That's not what Austin's supposed to be
doing. Austin is not supposed to be in that ring as a referee.
Well, if the other referee's incapacitated, what should he do?
Jerry, you have to admit, he's supposed to be an enforcer. He's not supposed to be
Goldberg.
You need to go explain something to him, Nate.
Hey,
explain his role. Explain his role.
Goldberg's held a submission.
Well, I guess if Stone Cold can do it, Nate can do it.
Well, Flair,
if Austin can get involved in this match and put his nose in it, then Flair can get involved.
Flair just pull Austin right out of the ring, and now he's assaulting Goldberg.
He can't do this. He's a general manager. He has no right putting his hands on Ric Flair.
I think Austin got provoked, and now Randy Orton.